Since 2011, 70,000 refugees have been registered in Yida camp in South Sudan, 15 kilometers from the border with Sudan. They are fleeing the Nuba Mountains in the Sudanese region of South Kordofan because of the war between the SPLM North Rebellion and government forces. We are in July, the rains have begun and they usually last until November. Last year, the mortality rate amongst young children was well above the emergency threshold during the rainy season, mostly because of infectious diseases due to poor hygiene conditions.
The lessons learned from last year were that malaria, diarrhea and acute respiratory infections were the main killers. So in order to prevent those diseases to spread in the camp this year, we launched a water and sanitation program. And at the moment, we're doing a vaccination campaign to prevent mainly, but not only, respiratory tract infections.
Well, this vaccination is special because this is the introduction of vaccination, a new vaccine or a new antigen in a population that is considered to be living in precarious conditions. This vaccine is not new. It has been introduced in several parts of the world. However, this is the first time, I believe, that in a refugee camp, in a situation like this, that we introduce such a vaccine.
Trying to bring the vaccines to South Sudan is quite difficult in some way. We have to use what is called the cold chain. The cold chain, the idea is that the vaccines have to come in a controlled temperature, a low controlled temperature between +2 and +8 degrees Celsius, and that has to come from the manufacturer until the patient receives the shot in the arm or in the leg. So that makes that your logistic capacity has to be really good to keep the vaccines in the adequate temperature for a long time.
Ideally, if we look to the future, what we would like to see is a whole new range of vaccines that are simpler to use, have extended sort of target populations, have simpler schedules, and of course are heat stable. 10 years ago, we were able to vaccinate in routine immunization against 6 vaccine preventable diseases, and it cost about $1.30. Today, we can vaccinate against a dozen or so vaccine preventable diseases, but a full course of vaccines will cost about $40. We've been offered donations, which is very generous, but we can't really develop a precedent that leaves us at the whim of the charity of the pharmaceutical industry.
The Gavi Alliance is a private Swiss foundation that buys vaccines for the world's poorest countries. Pfizer and GSK are the two companies that currently make the pneumonia vaccine. And to give an idea of how much money is made off of these vaccines, last year, Pfizer made more than $3.7 billion on the pneumonia vaccine alone. The Gavi Alliance has been able to negotiate lower prices for vaccines because they buy in large volumes. And this has been successful so far in reducing the prices of vaccines. Why they can't then extend the lowest global prices to humanitarian organizations like MSF is very questionable.
Today we're on the verge of starting a vaccination campaign against pneumococcal disease in Yida camp. What we would like to do is actually vaccinate all of the children under 5 against pneumococcal disease, but we simply can't afford that at the prices we're being made to pay for the pneumococcal vaccine. I don't think we really are asking to negotiate for Gavi prices, although we do think that Gavi should have a mechanism for making Gavi-priced vaccines available in an emergency. Beyond that, I think we want to ask for prices even better.